In today's tutorial, we'll take a quick look at how to do a cloud-to-cloud 3D inspection. In this example, we'll be working with this scan of a furnace which has been installed with graphite blocks. The 3D inspection will allow us to see how far or near each block is to the furnace. This can be useful if a certain thickness between the shell and the blocks is to be maintained. To get started, let's select both layers and head to the Inspections tab. Then choose 3D Inspection. Like with most RealWorks tools, you'll have the ability to either segment or sample the cloud before you begin the inspection. This can be useful to isolate areas, clean the cloud, or to downsample some points. Here we can also define our reference and comparison layers. In this case, the outer shell will be our reference. We can easily switch the two as well. You can also apply density correction to the comparison point cloud if your point cloud is not dense enough. This option only works for comparisons between two point clouds. We need to determine the maximum distance of the inspection. To figure this out, let's open up the Limit Box tool and take a few measurements of the furnace. We can hit F4 on the keyboard and select the cloud. We'll position it so we can see the difference between the two shells of the furnace. We can hide the limit box controls to get them out of the way. Find the measurement tool and select the 2D measurement option. We'll take a few measurements around the circumference of the two shells. This will give us an idea of the average distance between the two layers. We'll take a measurement around each side of the circumference to get an idea of the distances between the two shells. It looks like we're getting between 7 to 13 centimeters. So let's enter that in and hit compute. RealWorks will automatically generate a map based on the difference between the reference and comparison clouds, along with a legend to the left. As you can see, we have a small area missing. This is likely because the difference here exceeds the 13 centimeter max distance that we entered. Let's go ahead and change that to about 16 and compute this again. This looks a lot better. We're now able to analyze which blocks are sitting closer to the outer shell and which are sitting further away. Again, we can turn on the limit box and our outer shell to check out some of these measurements. In the 2D mode, we can take a few measurements. This yellow area should be in the 9 to 12 centimeter range. And finally, this red area is likely 14 to 16 centimeters. Before creating the inspection, we also have the option to filter out some points if we want to create the cloud within a certain range. This can also be done after creating the cloud as well. Let's go ahead and create the inspection. When it finishes, you'll notice we're left with a normal point cloud again. Let's view only our inspection cloud and then change the cloud color option to cloud color. Now, we see the inspection heat map again and we're able to analyze it as part of the point cloud. If you'd like to pull up the legend or filtering options, simply select the layer and find the 3D Inspection Analyzer. This will bring up the legend and the ability to filter out parts of the cloud. Let's try to filter out the areas 4 centimeters and less. You'll notice all the filtered points are shown in gray to give us a preview of what's being filtered out. When we choose Extract and Create, it will create a new cloud with the specified filter. Note that this is not another 3D inspection cloud and it doesn't contain the heat map that we generated. Finally, if you wish to share this inspection, you can export the layer. Highlight it and choose Export. We'll give it a name and choose E57 as the file type. If we choose this option to export inspection color as true color, This will overwrite the true color of the scan with the inspection heat map. What this allows us to do is to take the cloud into another 3D point cloud software and retain the inspection map as the cloud's true color. And that's a brief look into cloud-to-cloud 3D inspections. Please be sure to comment any questions, feedback, or ideas for future tutorials. And be sure to follow along for more RealWorks tips.